This land is your land, and this land is my land. From California to the New York Island, from the Redwood Forest to the Gulf Stream waters, this land was made for you and me.
Hello, my name is Geoff, and I will be the host of this short podcast series. The goal here is we're going to have 5 episodes or so, roughly 15 to 20 minutes, focused on learning more about the student farm at Penn State and ways for students, faculty, staff, local community members to get involved and learn more. Three things that are kind of going to be the overarching themes are experiential learning, building friendships, and reconnecting with the natural world. With the student farm, of course, as being one of the ways to achieve these three ideas. Over the next 4 episodes, we'll have students, professors, whoever it may be, coming in to talk about their experiences thus far, coming from a variety of educational backgrounds, whether it's agriculture, business, engineering, whatever it may be. Hoping to show that agriculture is something that affects all of us on an everyday basis, whether or not we are studying it in depth. For myself, I've been a part of the club for 1 year now. I've had the opportunity to volunteer on the farm a handful of times, and currently am one of the interns. So for me, it's been an incredible experience, one of learning a lot, and really overall just a very fulfilling experience. So part of the reasoning for this podcast series is to spread the awareness of this opportunity for people. For me, it's been very impactful. So knowing that there could be other people out there who could really benefit from this has been part of the motivations for making this happen. And of course, there's many ways to build friends and reconnect with the environment. But we're just hoping to show that this could be one of those ways of doing so. So for our first episode today, we will have Hayly Hoch on the show. Hayly, good to see you.
Thanks so much for having me, Jeff.
And Hayly is a senior in plant sciences, agroecology, and she was a key player in the formation of the student farm. And she is currently the co-director for the Student Farm Club, focusing on advocacy and outreach. So Hayly, glad to have you here. And we'll get more into, you know, your specific involvement and experience, but maybe if you could give us like a brief overview of what the student farm is, how it came to be, and anything like that.
Oh, well, I don't know if it'll be brief, but the student farm is a living laboratory facility here at Penn State that has become a part of the Sustainable Food Systems Program, which is a program that has been initiated, developed and led by students over the past 3 years here at Penn State. So I sort of came onto the scene at the very end of my freshman year. I'm a senior, like Geoff said, and had been in this sort of community of students that were looking for a way to continue conversations and continue learning about sustainability together, using food as sort of the connector between all of us. And so after a bit of researching and talking to faculty and staff here at the university, we sort of decided that a student farm was the perfect vehicle to continue that conversation and our learning together. So we spent my sophomore year with Leslie Pillen, our advisor and fearless leader, doing a lot of research on other institutions and universities' student farms. There are over 200. I don't know if you knew, across the U.S. that are already up and running and pretty established. So we thought Penn State should join the ranks, and the rest is history. We've been working for the past 3 years, and have had a lot of hurdles and a lot of challenges, but a lot of incredible successes that we're really proud of.
Awesome. Okay, and then maybe if you could speak about, you know, how you got involved, what was that kind of attracted you to the student farm?
Yeah, so as a freshman, I was involved in the Sustainable Agriculture Club. And to be honest, it wasn't much of a club at the time that I stepped onto the scene. it's certainly clubs here at Penn State go through ups and downs of membership and involvement. During my freshman year, it was a handful of us who would, you know, get together on Thursdays, and we would watch a lot of TED Talks and just have these really creative, cool conversations around food systems and what we thought that was and current research and current events. And we thought, you know, it'd be really wonderful to pool other people into this conversation. So like I said, we had some key faculty come visit us, including Dave Mortensen and Heather Karsten, and they told us that they had been hoping for the same. They wanted to do that alongside students, and they had actually submitted a proposal to the Sustainability Institute to hire a full-time staff to design and set up a student farm program here at Penn State, and that ended up being Leslie. So she came on the scene in April of my freshman year and started holding focus groups and visioning sessions. And so actually the summer after my freshman year, I went back home to little old Dillsburg, and nearby is Dickinson College. And so over that summer, I volunteered at the Dickinson Student Farm, and I fell in love. I was like, this is what I've been needing. This is what Penn State is missing for me. And actually, I considered transferring, but I sort of came around at the end of the summer and realized that I'd rather be a part of helping Leslie and those faculty to do the same, build the same thing here at Penn State, so that the people I was connecting with that first year and myself would have that experience close by and that we could make it our own. So from there on, my sophomore year, I was part of those visioning sessions and surveying, meeting with administrators, deans, and vice presidents and department heads, and then really jumped in junior year in co-founding the Student Farm Club with Carissa Hine and Kirsten Kerr. So that's when I think the gears really started turning, and students found the space that they could, their voice was really heard. So with the start of the Student Farm Club, we had our first hydroponics pilot. Students were really taking on the responsibility of getting the word out about the opportunity to learn about sustainability through food, and that got a lot of attention from media, from the community, from the administrators, and I think that's when we really got the ball rolling on what this could look like at Penn State.
Awesome. Very cool. It sounds like, you know, you had the opportunity to go somewhere else and work on a currently existing program, but instead you stayed at Penn State to create, you know, its own, which is very cool.
Yeah.
And it sounds like in the club itself, there are opportunities also to like start your own projects and really, you know, have a lot of creativity. And it sounds like it's something that you've definitely, you know, done with the student farm.
Yeah. So throughout this, we, the whole process and in those beginning visioning sessions, it became very clear that everyone had a different way to plug in to food or sustainability and the things that they wanted to learn more about. They had really unique perspectives or skills or backgrounds, fields that they were coming from. And so we knew that having this program be really diverse and sort of make it your own model was so important. And I think we've really preserved that, not only, so in the club, we have project teams and Geoff, you know this, but you know, we have multiple project teams that focus on everything from production, sustainable production, to food chain sustainability, which will cover food waste, or education in food, but all sorts of things. So whenever you're on a project team, you can really sort of take ownership of your own experience and decide what projects you're going to jump onto and develop for yourself so that you can really meet the needs of what you want to do. And then sort of zooming out, not only in the club, but we also have a bunch of different ways that students in general can get involved with the student farm. So you can be a club member, or, you know, maybe you're in a class that's doing a project as a client course for us. Or you're an intern like Geoff, and you're getting connected with us that way. So there or really just a volunteer that can come out to our service learning days, or, you know, shows up in Redifer when we have an event. So there's a bunch of really diverse ways to engage, to really facilitate that, you know, that need of students to plug in unique ways.
And if you stick with us over the next four episodes, we're going to dive deeper into those four specific things, you know, internships, volunteering, working through a class at the student farm, and then the club itself. But maybe, you know, coming back to these three core concepts of experiential learning, of building friendships, and, you know, connecting with nature and all that that entails. Maybe starting off with experiential learning, like, what does that mean to you, and how is, you know, working with the student farms kind of promoted that or made that possibility?
I think experiential education is really using the spark of the initial lesson that maybe comes from the classroom and then putting it into practice, not only for yourself, but then I think experiential education also allows you to interact with people and have that collaborative learning, co-learning happen really organically. That doesn't necessarily happen in our classrooms as easily.
Very cool. And then how about, I'm sure you can talk about this one for hours, but, you know, building friendships and community through the club. Maybe you could talk a bit about that.
Yeah, absolutely. And again, this is one of those things, just looking for that community, that consistent community was one of the top priorities for me the first year that, you know, before Leslie even got here and we put a name to what this program is, having the space and the connections built in where I knew that if I didn't know something or if I was struggling with something in learning about sustainability or agriculture, a community is a way that when you're plugged in, someone will be there with a really unique set of skills that maybe you're missing to lend a hand and work through these issues with you. And then also just the incredible support that we have in our community at all levels. So I've met my best friends through this program and building this program. I've had the opportunity to connect with my greatest mentors as well. And all of those people have been really supportive in building this dream here. And then also, you know, all of us have a dream for what happens after life at Penn State, and those people have been really integral in building me up and making me feel confident in the direction that I want to go or the impact that I want to make. So this community has just been the greatest source of strength that I've had here at Penn State.
Very cool. Yeah, kind of like you were saying, something about, you know, forming those relationships, and in some way it does tie into the experiential learning, is very much hands-on working with others. So in some way, you know, you're killing two birds with one stone.
Exactly. They definitely overlap.
Yeah. And then the final one would be, you know, connecting with nature. Kind of a broad term, but, you know, it's so much of our day-to-day lives are in classrooms, sitting down, going from, you know, building to building. But it seems like a lot of the, you know, opportunities at the student farm are you're out there, you know, getting dirty, working with your hands. How has that affected you, and, you know, why might you recommend someone experience nature in that way?
Yeah, so actually, this was one of my greatest aha moments, and it was before the student farm again, my freshman year. I was sort of in that space of, I actually wasn't in my major yet. I was in the College of Ag and interested in plant science, but was sort of bopping around, like, hadn't really made the connection yet or jumped into or figured out why food was so important to me. I knew I really loved ecology, I loved plant science, so I was thinking maybe I would be more useful in the environmental sciences if I really want to make an impact, a positive change. How do I do what I like and what I'm passionate about, but also create a positive impact? So I was like, well, probably environmentalism is like where that's at. And then one day I was walking through the woods with a friend of mine, Evan Gover, and he was a senior, and I looked up to him a lot, and he was having a conversation with someone ahead of me, and I was just listening in, and this one sound bite, like, changed my life. At one point he said, well, food is our closest connection to the earth. It's the way that we interact with the environment and the earth every day. And I can't tell you, like, I stopped frozen in my tracks, and it was like everything, all the puzzle pieces sort of came together for me. You know, I had cared about plant science and crop science. I had cared about ecology and the earth and conservation. But then I also, you know, had cared about connecting people to food. And at one point, these three things came together for me. And I was like, this is where I'm supposed to be. Like,
right.
I am on the right track. And now I know why I'm here. And it sort of just really solidified that for me. So that has been sort of my hidden mission this whole time is, you know, food does all of these amazing things and as a tool to bring us together and build community, but it's also a way to more easily connect people to a love for the environment, for nature, for the earth that maybe they hadn't cultivated for themselves before, and I'd love to be a part of making that happen.
Great. Beautiful story there. Never heard that. I think you bring up a key point is that food is something that we all eat every day. And, you know, for yourself, you're in the College of Ag, you know, studying plant sciences. So this is probably, you know, the student farm is something you're maybe more intensely focused in production and all the intricacies. Whereas, you know, there's plenty of other students who are, you know, studying business or engineering, but who are also interested in this whole, you know, student farm. And I think part of it speaks to the fact is that you don't have to be, you know, a farmer or in ag to be into understanding where our food comes from and being connected in that sense. I think, you know, what you just said speaks very much to that.
Absolutely.
Yeah. So I guess to kind of wrap up, maybe what are some final lessons learned or maybe a few final takeaways that you have or things you'd like to share with someone who's on the fence, who's thinking, you know, is this for me? Is this not for me? What's something you might tell that person right now?
Yeah, I would say we talked a lot about sort of the beginning of the student farm here and how I initially got involved. But I would say that the process of building this program isn't over. And that's something that really has hooked a lot of people maybe at Penn State is it's hard to leave your mark here. It's so big. It's such a big place. You know, you feel like a face, one face in a sea of thousands. But the student farm for a lot of people, myself included, has been a way that you're creating a tangible impact here on campus, one that's really important and had been a void previously. So it hadn't been filled before. And we have 1 acre right now that we're growing on, but we can only be there for a limited amount of time, maybe another 2 or 3 years. So I won't be here to really see the continuation of the building of the student farm, but we need to keep this ball rolling. And there's a need to expand production so that we can learn about all different types of growing. You know, right now we're just doing fresh vegetables and fruits, but we want to do you know, orchard and agronomic crops and all sorts of things. So that requires more land. And so that's going to be a continued conversation with administrators on how do we keep expanding this program so that even more students and even more community members, faculty and staff are included in building this and benefiting from it. So if you want to leave your mark during your time here at Penn State, this is a great way to get your toes wet. So just jump in. You're gonna be a part of something that's really important and that you'll be able to come back and say, you know, I helped this along and I had a hand in making
right. The
student farm at Penn State.
Definitely. And through that process of furthering the goals of the student farm, you know, there's so many skills and lessons learned along the way.
Gosh.
And it's almost like that end goal. We're almost always too focused on the end goal, but there's so much in the process that we learn,
which is
incredibly powerful.
So true.
So Hayly, thank you for being on the podcast today, or the first person.
I feel very honored.
Ground. Yeah.
Oh, fantastic. Thank you so much, Geoff, for having me.
And if people have any questions, is there a way to contact you, or what might be the best way if someone was interested in learning more?
Yeah, absolutely. If you want to learn more about the student farm and the sustainable food systems in general, we have an amazing website that our communications and media interns have worked on. It's sites.psu.edu/studentfarm. So definitely check that out. We're on Facebook, so if you search Student Farm at Penn State, you can find our page, and that's regularly updated with great blog posts by interns like Geoff, as well as some upcoming events that we have that you can come out to and support us, volunteer days, all sorts of things. And then if you have any questions, you can always reach out to me. My email is hrh5091@psu.edu, and I'm sure Geoff is more than capable of answering any questions as well. So definitely reach out to him.
Great. And then there'll be a link to the listserv below, so you can just send a blank email to that if you want to be updated with the weekly reminders. Very, very interesting stuff. So, thank you again, Hayly.
Thank you, Geoff. This was great.